Hi guys, my name is Rakesh. Now I'm going to give a presentation on input-output fundamentals based on CAO. What are peripheral devices? There are two types of peripheral devices: input-output subsystem and peripheral subsystems. Input-output subsystems are which provides an efficient mode of communication between the central system and the outside environment. Peripheral systems are input or output devices attached to the computer. Examples: monitor, keyboard, printer, storage devices. What is an input-output interface? Which provides a method for transferring information between the internal storage and external input-output devices. General differences between the computer and peripheral devices. A conversion of single signal values may be required for peripheral electromechanical devices. For CPU or memory, electronic devices. Data transfer rate for peripheral devices, it will be slower. For CPU or memory, it will be faster than peripherals. Some kind of synchronization mechanism may be needed. Unit of information for peripherals, it's bytes. For CPU or memory, it's words. Operating modes, peripherals, it is autonomous and asynchronous. For CPU or memory, it's synchronous. These are some ASCII alpha numerical characters. Suppose 000 and 001, 0010, etc. These are some control characters. Null, null represents null. SOH, start of heading. STS, start of text, etc. What is an interface unit? Special hardware components between the CPU and the peripherals. Supervise and synchronize all inputs and output transfers. Resolves the difference between the computer and peripheral devices. What is an input-output bus? Input-output bus, which transfers the information between the CPU and the input-output devices through input-output interface. Input-output bus consists of data lines, address lines, and control lines. This is the connection of input-output bus to input-output devices. The processor consists of three data lines, which is data, address, and control. And this is linked up to interface and the external devices, keyboard, printer, magnetic disk, and magnetic tape. What is an input-output command? Function code from processor. These input-output commands are of four types. Control command, which is issued to activate the peripheral and to inform it what to do. Status command, tests various status conditions in the interface and the peripheral. Input command, interface receives data from peripheral and places it in its buffer register. Output command, interface transfers information from the bus to its registers. We'll compare input-output bus versus memory bus. Input-output bus transfers information between CPU and input-output devices through input-output interface. What is a memory bus? Transfers information between the CPU and the main memory. Like input-output bus, memory bus consists of data lines, address lines, and control lines. Now we'll discuss about the ways in which computer bus can be used to communicate with the memory and input. There are three ways. The first one is use two separate buses, one for memory and other for input-output. And the second way is use one command bus for both memory and input-output, but have separate control lines for each. And the third one is use one command bus for memory and input-output with common control lines. Many computers use a common single bus system for both memory and input-output interface units. Now we'll compare isolated mapped input-output devices and memory mapped input-output devices. Isolated input-output devices, in the sense, separate input-output read-write control lines in addition to the memory read-write control lines, and the separate memory and input-output address spaces. Distinct input and output instructions. When CPU fetches and decodes the output code of an input-output instruction, it places the address into the common address lines. Also enables read-write control lines. The address in the address lines is for interface register and not for memory. Whereas in case of memory mapped input-output, a single set of read-write control lines is used, and memory and input-output address shares the common address space and reduces the memory address range available. No specific input or output instruction is not required. Considerably flexibility in handling input-output operations. And what is an input-output mapping? This same we discussed in the last slide. This will be the structural diagram for memory mapped input-output and input-output mapped input-output. Example for input-output interface. This consists of bus buffer and timing and control and four types of registers: port A register, port B register, control register, and status register. In this way, it works. Asynchronous data transfer means. Now we'll discuss about synchronous data transfer first. All data transfer occur simultaneously during the occurrence of a clock pulse. Registers in the interface share a common clock with CPU registers in asynchronous data transfer. Whereas in asynchronous data transfer, internal timing in each input, each unit is independent. Each unit uses its own private clock for internal registers and no common clock for asynchronous data transfer. There are two types of asynchronous data transfer methods, strobe pulse and handshaking. Strobe pulse means a strobe pulse is supplied by one of the units to indicate when the transfer has to occur to the other units. Handshaking. A control signal is accompanied with each data being transmitted to indicate the presence of data. The receiving unit responds with other control signal to acknowledge the receipt of the data. Now we'll go briefly about strobe control. It employs a single control line to time each other. The strobe may be activated by either the source or the destination unit. The data bus carries the binary information from source to destination. Source initiated strobe. This is the other type of strobe control. It could be a memory written control signal from the CPU to a unit. Source is a CPU, places a word on the data bus and informs the memory unit which is destination, that is a write operation. The disadvantage of source initiated strobe is no way of knowing whether the destination unit has actually received. We can get that from this diagram. And the other type is destination initiated strobe. It could be a memory read control signal, same as strobe initiated control. And the destination CPU initiates the read operation to inform the memory which is the source to place a selected word into the data bus. What is the disadvantage is no way of knowing whether the source has actually placed the data on the bus. It's the same as the before thing. Now we'll discuss about handshaking. To solve the disadvantage of strobe, the handshake method introduces a second control signal to provide a reply to the unit that initiates the transfer. There are two types of handshaking: source initiated transfer and destination initiated transfer. Handshaking provides high degree of flexibility and reliability. An incompletion of data transfer can be detected by means of timeout mechanism, which is an advantage over strobe mechanism. The timeout signal can be used to interpret the processor and hence execute a service routine that takes appropriate error recovery reaction. Source initiated data transfer using handshake. This is the block diagram of the timing diagram. This is a sequence of events which can be operated by handshaking. Destination initiated data transferring using handshaking. This is the block diagram of it, and these are the various steps that undergoes in destination unit. What are the problems that occur due to the input output devices? Wide variety of peripherals delivering different amount of data at different speeds in different formats, all slower than CPU and RAM, need input output modules. These are the problems that are faced due to input output devices. Input output modules, interface to CPU and memory and interface to one or more peripherals. This is a generic model of input module which consists of address lines, data lines, control lines and input output module. What are the functions of input output modules? The control and timing, the CPU communication, the device communication and the data buffering and the error detection. Input output steps. Steps needed to transfer data to or from external device to CPU. The first step is CPU checks the input output module device status. And the second is input output module written status. And the third is if the input output module is ready, the CPU requests data transfer. Then the input module gets the data from the device. And the input output module transfers the data to the CPU. This is the input output module diagram, which consists of data registers, control registers, input output logic, and external devices, and the external device logic. And in this is known as interface to system bus, and this will be interface to external bus. And the data is transferred from external device storage to data, or it can be vice versa. The status is implemented to external device interface logic, and the control is given out. And similarly, for the external device, the same data is transferred vice versa, and the status and the control. For the data register and system register, we use data lines to transfer this. And address lines are linked to input output logic, and control lines are linked to input output logic. Here, input output logic acts as a base for all data register and status register, or external device to interface logic and external device interface logic. And now I end my presentation. Thank you.